Hi, I'm Zara.
Hi, I'm Panav.
Hi, I'm Audrey.
Hi, I'm Caitlin.
In terms of how long we've been a part of this project, we all started around about year 9 and currently we're in year 12, so it's been about 3 or 4 years.
I've been involved in compassionate systems starting from year 9 after meeting Gus for a 3-day workshop at our school where we were introduced to the framework and tools. Over these 2-3 years, I've been a part of various projects and undertakings inside of BSJ as well as in the international landscape. Within BSJ, we expanded the compassionate systems framework throughout the school, contributing our ideas to the school's core values of head, heart, self, and system, teaching the tools to younger students such as year 5s and year 6s, as well as our peers. I've also been involved in multiple international collaborations and projects. I am one of 3 school representatives to become an ambassador for MIT Sloan's Climate Initiative and learn their climate simulator. I had the opportunity to interact with various educators around the world, as well as work with the science teachers at BSJ to guide MRP students in their climate change projects using the simulator. I've also been in the Youth Council with Gus Rask and the Center for Systems Awareness team, meeting regularly with the students from different countries such as Thailand, Denmark, Nepal, and Switzerland.
It was a new opportunity that interested all of us. We really wanted to take this opportunity to learn how to be a more careful, critical thinker. And so we became intrigued to join and find out more. And to look at problems from a more objective point of view and to understand all the root causes of our daily problems.
When the school brought up the opportunity to become an ambassador in year 9, I was curious about the program and how it would benefit my personal development. A key moment that encouraged me to commit was a well-being and compassionate systems conference held at our school during our first year of being student ambassadors. In this 2-3-day event, not only did BSJ teachers and staff members join the conversations, but also educators from other schools in Jakarta and other countries came together. We interacted with them at a similar level, sharing our thoughts and opinions, breaking the typical classroom setting of the teacher-student hierarchy. Personally, I really enjoyed the opportunity as it allowed us to freely voice our experiences and hold worthwhile conversations with the educators.
I think the most important thing for me was that it helped me make my thought process more structured.
The compassionate learning systems equipped me with many tools.
I'm now able to look at problems and situations in a more ground-to-top basis, and I'm able to look at them in a more deep manner.
As well as helped me connect with like-minded people from around the world.
So I'm not only looking at the issues on their face value, but I'm also looking at the root causes and various external factors that could affect the issues. I think a lot of people tend to ignore these kinds of things when they're looking at a problem or an event.
CS tools don't directly shift our beliefs and values, but they rather change the way we think and the process by which we perceive information at events, such that we have a more holistic approach. For example, the iceberg tool helps us identify the connections between events that we directly experience with underlying patterns and structures that influence these events. These underlying structures include societal norms and beliefs, but also tangible objects and systems that shape the event we see above the surface. It helps me see different factors affecting an event so I can better understand what components to take into consideration when solving a problem, what limitations there are when making decisions, and how to manage projects to get better results.
My favorite experience so far is probably teaching the year 3, year 5, and year 6 children in our school.
We worked with students from UWC,
Global Cause, as well as a newfound group called the Youth Council, which connects youth who are like-minded from around the world.
It was a really interesting experience since they were very engaging and showed a lot of interest when we explained the tools to them.
So currently we're running another project with this school in China. However, we ran a similar project a few months back, and in this project, we got to spend a lot of time going through things such as workshops and experiences with students from UWC. Now, unfortunately, this was an online experience, so it wasn't as great as it possibly could have been. But I really do believe that the experience I had of communicating with these kids from another school in another country, you know, very different cultures and experiences, that was quite interesting for myself personally. Also, learning alongside them, with some of them having more experience, some of them having less experience, meant that we could all learn something from each other. And as always, new perspectives, they improve the breadth of your knowledge.
It was a really unique experience since we didn't expect as much interest from younger kids, but we're really eager and excited to learn more about it. Since the compassionate learning system tools really focuses on our well-being and our mental health, I think it's really important for students to remember that academics isn't everything. Since a lot of schoolwork actually add on to our workload and our school pressure, it's important to remember to focus on our own well-being and mental health.
I think the one biggest advice that teachers who are trying to implement this tool should consider is that these tools are not meant for academic improvements. The main improvement that one would gain from such tools is firstly structuring their thoughts well, as me and my friends had previously mentioned, and secondly, being more aware in like social situations. So there are certain tools that are part of the system to help you be a bit more empathetic towards those you're around, not just out of courtesy, but I think because you're trying to understand their situations and their problems a bit more, and which is why I think this tool is quite great. But at the same time, teachers and students alike should not expect there to be academic improvements from these tools, because that's just not the focus of these. There's many other tools that can help you improve academically, and to an extent, structuring your thoughts may help in the academic side, but that's not the key focus of these. It's more to do with the social aspect, as well as just the way your mind processes thoughts, problems, and circumstances.
As a climate ambassador, like I mentioned before, one of the most memorable experiences was working with the BSJ science faculty to help facilitate the NYP interdisciplinary unit. It was very exciting. I did this 2 years in a row for year 8 students using the MIT Sloan climate tool. And recently, within the topic of how changes in population affect climate change, I and a couple others guided the students in using this climate simulation as a tool to justify and support deductions and conclusions in their projects. Another memorable experience was visiting a local community center called the Wada Foundation prior to the pandemic. This organization provides educational opportunities for young children in underprivileged communities. So we played a variety of games with them and introduced simple compassionate systems concepts such as the floor player model and clear advocacy. Several months later, when the pandemic hit, I realized the community would be much economically impacted by these circumstances, and I organized and led a project to create care packages for 100 of these families that contain basic needs such as rice, sugar, milk, soap, and children's activity books. Students spend a lot of time at school and are influenced by the values developed in school, as well as opportunities provided for further growth. Thus, the school community plays a big, big role in their development. Schools can provide workshops and conferences to train them on the framework and tools. For example, with Gus and the Center for Systems Awareness team, that will equip them with the knowledge of how systems, patterns, and mental models interact to help them become better leaders. Through this, the students will be able to master the tools while developing their communication and interpersonal skills, which are all crucial in forming a good leader. Student leaders should also help train younger students. As from my experience, younger students tend to look up to older students and therefore will more readily adopt their attitudes and actions. This allows ambassadors to further develop their leadership qualities while also helping to cultivate young leaders' skills.